Tiffany. How are you? Are you guys still there? First of all, thank you for having me. It's such an honor to me. And seriously, what have I gotten myself into? I'm gonna look like a potato compared to you guys. I mean, you guys are impressive. So, first of all, I won't be able to speak English the whole time. Like I said, I'm gonna look like a potato if I speak full English. So I'm gonna use campur-campur. Like if I don't have the word, I'm gonna use Bahasa Indonesia, if that's okay with you guys. Okay, nama saya Leony. That's me. And maybe some of you know me, some of you doesn't know me. I'm an actress now, but I start as a child singer since I was very little. So maybe the parents know me, but the kids don't know me. Am I right? Okay. So what I'm going to talk about is about being your true self in the middle of social conformity. Why did I choose this topic? Jadi, ini adalah sesuatu yang agak personal buat saya, karena saya dari kecil udah tumbuh di public. So, I grew up in public's eyes. Like, literally, everybody see me since I was 5 years old. So, saya akan selalu jadi orang yang tumbuh di mata publik, yang people will tell me what to do, what to wear, how to act, and yeah, dan saya ada di dunia yang orang-orang akan mengatur saya, apa yang saya lakukan, apa yang harus saya pakai, apa yang harus saya perbuat. Jadi kayak my whole life selalu ada orang yang dictates what to do. Jadi how I find myself, my true self di tengah-tengah itu, ditambah dari masih kecil banget, jadi kayak I still haven't figured out my personality. I still haven't figured out what I want to do in life. I still haven't figured out what I like, what I don't like, because I've been on public's eyes since I was 5 years old. So this is based on what I've experienced from my own life. Okay, tapi sebelumnya mari kita lihat sedikit, what is social conformity? Social conformity is a type of social influence involving a change in belief or behaviors in order to fit in with a group. Humans have a common tendency to adopt the opinions and follow the behaviors of the majority. Jadi kita akan selalu, like, it's a human nature to want to be accepted by a group, by people. It's normal. And then we have a normative social influence. It's where a person conforms in order to be accepted and belong to a group. They do this because it is socially rewarding to avoid social rejection. Like, we don't want to be ridiculed for not fitting in, and that's what people do. Kayak, kalau ada mayoritas yang beropini seperti ini, beropini A, terus ada minoritas yang beropini B, si A ini akan merasa superior, and they can bully orang-orang yang beropini B. Nah, sometimes in order to avoid that, even kita personally, I prefer B. Tapi daripada gue dibully, okay, I choose A. Dan, yeah, sometimes we just let it be. At least kita di-accept sama orang-orang sekitar kita. Yaudah kita ikutin aja lah. Jadi sometimes, even ourselves, we cannot like truly honest with ourselves. Karena kita mikirin katanya orang-orang. Ah, nanti gue diomongin nih kalau gue ngomongnya kayak gini. Ah, nanti gue diomongin nih kalau gue berpenampilan kayak gini. Like, ya saya sendiri pada saya pertama potong rambut pendek, oh, netizen berbicara. They know me since I was a kid with long hair, like a pretty skirt, very feminine, like a cute little thing. And when I grow up, well, this is how I look like. I cut my hair short, I dye my color, my hair color, and they just complain because they feel they know me. Like, you shouldn't have your hair cut like that. You should have your long hair until I die. You should still be cute and girly and wear skirts all the time. That's what they expect from me. Terus apa saya nurut mereka? Hell no. Nope, nope, nope. This is me. And apakah saya dapat negative impact? Of course. People bullying me on social media. They talk poop about me. Harus saya sensor ya. But kalau saya nurutin mereka, apakah mereka akan lebih accept saya? Of course. But will that make me happy? Of course not. Because I'd be lying. I'm just living what everybody expect me to live. Not my true self. And I prefer like, saya gak butuh semua orang accept saya. Yang penting saya accept diri saya sendiri. Why? This is my life. I'm the one who's gonna live with it, not you guys. So, how to stay true to yourself? First, be brave. Jangan pernah takut. Jangan pernah takut untuk keluar dari circle yang tidak suportif. Jangan pernah takut untuk speak your mind. Berani untuk, kalau saya melakukan ini, itu gak ada manfaatnya buat saya. Why should I do that? Berani speak up your mind, figure out what you want to do. Kayak, okay, waktu zaman saya SMA, seumur kalian ini, teman-teman saya lagi zaman banget clubbing. Every weekend, clubbing. Oh, ada klub baru buka, clubbing. Di sini ada klub baru, musiknya enak, clubbing. Terus, it's my friends, my circle of friends. I tried clubbing once. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love good music, I love to dance. Tapi suasana clubbing gak enak buat saya. So I told my friends, okay, I love you guys, but I'm not just gonna come with you if you guys go clubbing. It's just not my thing. As simple as that. Kita gak harus selalu ngikutin, oh, circle kita sukanya ini, kita ikutin aja semua. Circle kita suka ini, kita ikutin aja semua. Kita gak akan pernah bisa nemuin diri kita kalau kita hanya ngikutin apa kata orang-orang. Second, feel a lot of things. Jangan pernah takut untuk memperbanyak experience, pengalaman. Kayak, saya masih gak tahu nih, kan gak, kita itu hidup gak akan selalu tahu apa yang kita mau. Ada saatnya kita kayak empty shell aja. Hidup jalanin aja, gak tahu. Kayak, ya udah deh, disuruhnya apa, ikutin aja. Karena kita juga gak tahu apa maunya kita. That's why we have to feel a lot of things. We have to experience a lot of things. Okay, kayak ada, apa ya, kayaknya hidup gue gini aja nih, bosen. Cari, cobain aja semuanya. Maybe you will find what you like, what you want to do in life. Kalau kita gak experience itu semua, how do we know? Kita kan cuma menjalani hidup ya gitu aja. Disuruhnya sekolah, lulus sekolah ditentuin, mau kuliahnya apa. Abis kuliah ditentuin, kerjanya di sini ditentuin. Ya, hidupnya ngikutin gitu aja. We will never find our true self if we just follow. Next, don't stop searching for meaning. Ya, ibaratnya kalau kita belum ketemu apa yang kita mau, jangan menyerah, jangan berhenti. You have to find your passion. Jangan kayak baru nyoba 1-2 udah kayak, ah, nyerah deh gue, udah nggak tahu deh hidup mau ngapain, ikutin aja sesuai kata orang-orang. Kita lihat, oh si A hidupnya kayaknya enak nih, kita ikutin aja nih dia jalannya kayak gimana, kita ikutin aja. No, lo nggak akan pernah bisa feel content about yourself kalau lo hanya ngikutin rulesnya orang-orang, karena every individual is unique. Setiap dari kita punya jalannya masing-masing. We have to find it. That's why don't stop searching. Search within yourself. Setiap kita ngelakuin apapun, ya kita dialog sama diri sendiri. This is what I want to do. This is what I like to do. This is how I want to other people see me for the rest of our lives. Does this make me feel content? Is this something I can live for the rest of my life? Cari terus, sampai kita bisa kayak, yes, this is what I want in my life. This is how I want to be. And next, find a goal. Kalau kita punya goal, kayak, okay, in the next 5 years, kita punya certain goal, we work towards it, and we can be proud. Even kita gak mencapai goal itu, wah ternyata kayak, masih butuh 5 tahun lagi. But we can be proud. Why? Because we already work for it. This is our goal, and I'm pretty sure if you work towards your goal, it will make you proud of yourself, and you can feel confident. So if everybody telling you, oh, you cannot do that, you have to be like this, you can be proud and say, no, I can do this, and I will do this, because this is what I want to achieve. So it's very important to have a goal. Like, goal tuh kayak apa sih? Misalnya kayak saya. Yeah, I want to do whatever I want. Goal saya simple. Saya gak mau orang-orang nentuin lagi kayak, oh, kamu harus berpakaian seperti ini, kamu harus rambutnya seperti ini. I mean, my hair is normal now, but I still rebel. Masih saya botakin rambut saya setengah. And how to achieve that? Saya gak pernah takut untuk menyuarakan suara saya, menyuarakan opini saya, menyuarakan pendapat saya, menyuarakan keinginan saya. And yeah, this is who I am. If you want to accept, good. If you don't want to accept, deal with it. It's not my problem. It's your problem. So my goal adalah to be bodo amat. And how do I achieve that? Always be honest with myself. And somehow, it makes my life easier. Gak perlu lagi acceptance dari orang-orang yang tidak ada signifikannya dalam hidup saya. Yang kayak dia tidak juga menghidupi hidup saya. Cuma bisa berkomentar aja. Jadi, why would I worry about that? Jadi, once I set my mind in that goal, goal saya itu jadi bodo amat, I gain much more confident. And why? Because I already accept myself. I don't need you guys to accept me because I already accept myself. In the end, nobody is perfect, but we can always strive to be better version of ourselves. Acknowledge our insecurities and do something about it so it became our strength. Jadi, bukan berarti kita juga harus perfect. No, nobody is perfect. Tapi, apakah kita bisa accept? Apa kita bisa menerima insecurities kita? Jadi kita gak harus ngerasa selalu orang-orang harus menerima saya. You accept yourself. Jadi kita gak perlu-perlu banget mendapat pengakuan dari orang lain. Okay, thank you for listening. Have a good day, everybody. Thank you.